This voice annotated presentation is about focal seizures. After this presentation, you should be able to define what a seizure is and what is meant by epilepsy. You should know the two types of seizures, focal and generalized, and be able to distinguish between the two. You should also be able to describe a focal seizure using standard terminology proposed by the International League Against Epilepsy in 2010. An epileptic seizure is the result of abnormal excessive activity of neurons in the brain. They may also be abnormal synchronization of neuronal activity. This results in various physical, sensory, and other non-physical manifestations, which we will discuss later. Epilepsy is a condition in which a person is prone to having recurrent epileptic seizures. This implies that there is a disorder in the brain, and there should be at least one epileptic seizure for the diagnosis. During your reading, you may have encountered the term partial seizure. This was the term used for an epileptic seizure where the first clinical and electroencephalographic change indicates activation of a system of neurons limited to one cerebral hemisphere. This is equivalent to a focal seizure under the new classification. The new definition of a focal seizure is that of a seizure originating from a point within networks limited to one hemisphere. The disorders are the same, but the terminology and definition have been changed to better reflect our current understanding of seizures. Generalized seizures are still called generalized seizures in the new terminology. However, the definition has changed slightly. Previously, it was defined as a seizure where the first changes indicate initial simultaneous involvement of both hemispheres. It is now thought that a generalized seizure originates at some point within the brain but rapidly engages bilateral networks distributed across both cerebral hemispheres. Hence, the first changes seen clinically or electrographically involve both hemispheres. A focal seizure, as mentioned earlier, originates from networks within one hemisphere. It may be localized to a portion of the hemisphere or be more widespread. It may also originate from subcortical structures. Each seizure usually originates from the same source and its pattern of spread is similar between episodes. In some individuals, there can be more than one epileptic network and seizure type. However, each of these has a consistent locus where it first starts. Under the older classification, there was differentiation between seizures where consciousness was impaired versus those where it was not. There is no such differentiation with the new classification. Focal seizures may spread to involve the contralateral hemisphere. Under the old classification, these were referred to as secondarily generalized seizures. The classification into simple partial, complex partial, and secondarily generalized seizures is thought to be artificial and arbitrary. Under the new classification, focal seizures are described according to their semiology. These can be motor, autonomic, disconnective, or auras. The degree of impairment of consciousness should be described. Focal seizures without impairment of consciousness are described according to their observable motor and autonomic manifestations. Those with subjective sensory or psychic phenomena are described as having an aura. Hence, an example of a description of a focal seizure is a focal motor seizure with no impairment of consciousness with clonic jerking of the right upper limb and autonomic features of facial flushing with a preceding aura of tingling in the affected limb. Seizures with impairment in consciousness or awareness were previously called complex partial seizures. The ILAE has proposed the term disconnective to describe this feature of focal seizures. Seizures that evolve to involve the opposite hemisphere, previously called secondarily generalized seizures, are now described as evolving into a bilateral convulsive seizure and the motor features, tonic, clonic, and their components described accordingly. Semiology is a study of how the seizure manifests. The human homunculus shows how an abnormal discharge in different parts of the brain can have manifestations on corresponding parts of the body and their functions. Seizures can be manifested as auras and symptoms and signs which affect motor, autonomic, and awareness functions. Aura is a subjective perceptual disturbance experienced by the patient. There are various types of auras which involve the whole range of human perception. They can be somatosensory, visual, auditory, olfactory, gustatory, cephalic, epigastric, affective, and mnemonic. Motor seizures are described by the actions produced. Tonic seizures are sustained muscle contractions lasting seconds to minutes. Dystonic seizures are contractions of agonist and antagonist muscle groups resulting in abnormal posturing. Myoclonic seizures are sudden brief muscle contractions. Clonic seizures are repetitive alternate contractions of agonist and antagonist muscle pairs, often resulting in involuntary repetitive movements. Progressive seizures affect ischial muscles, resulting in sustained rotation from the midline. They can affect the cephalic and truncal muscles. When it affects the eye muscles, it causes conjugate eye deviation. When seizures involve the autonomic nervous system, the manifestations may be pseudomotor, vasomotor, cardiovascular, gastrointestinal, and thermoregulatory. In summary, focal seizures are due to excessive and abnormally synchronous discharges of neurons in one part of the cerebral hemisphere. The onset and spread is usually similar between episodes. The manifestations vary according to networks involved. Focal seizures should be described by their symptom manifestations.